have some breaking news for you now. The White House just confirmed to me that President Trump sent a letter to Turkey's president on October 9th. Let me read you the letter. It is quite something. Dear President Erdogan, this is a week ago, October 9th, so this is before the president announced his troop withdrawal from northern Syria. Dear Mr. President, President of Turkey, quote, let's work out a good deal. You don't want to be responsible for slaughtering thousands of people, and I don't want to be responsible for destroying the Turkish economy, and I will. I've already given you a little sample with respect to Pastor Brunson. I have worked hard to solve some of your problems. Don't let the world down. You can make a great deal. General Mazlum is willing to negotiate with you, and he is willing to make concessions that they would never have made in the past. I am confidentially enclosing a copy of his letter to me just received. History will look upon you favorably if you get this done the right and humane way. It will look upon you forever as the devil if good things don't happen. Don't be a tough guy. Don't be a fool. I will call you later. Sincerely, Donald Trump. So I have to say, I saw this letter. We should note that it was broken by Trish Regan of Fox Business News. I saw this letter and I thought it was a joke. I thought it was a hoax. But then I sent it to Stephanie Grisham, the White House press secretary, and she said it was real.
I mean, you don't want to laugh because it is a very serious issue, but it is very emblematic of Donald Trump's style, essentially saying, like, do the right thing or everyone's going to think of you as the devil and, like, by the way, I'll call you later. I don't think this is what these letters normally look like when you send this kind of thing. But it's pretty clear that Erdogan didn't heed these warnings. I mean, he didn't take this very seriously, obviously, and that's the position we're in right now. But it's just a striking window into how the president operates one-on-one with world leaders.
And I'm told I misspoke earlier that the president announced the troop withdrawal on the 6th, on Sunday the 6th. So this is a letter he sent to the Turkish president after he'd already announced. And so he was saying, even though the troops have been taken back, Erdogan, don't slaughter the Syrians, let's make a deal. Your response
to
this?
So I of course have a different viewpoint, right? This president's tweeted this out. I think he's trying to make it abundantly clear to Erdogan that this is the best deal he's going to get with the general leading the Kurdish Defense Forces, the SDF there, Mazlun.
What deal is there?
I don't know what deal. I don't know. He said I'm enclosing General Mazlun's letter. Enclosed here within, I think is what it said. So I'm not quite sure what deal they were trying to cut. I don't know, but.
Do you support the withdrawal of the U.S.?
Yeah, no, I like Senator Paul and Senator Tim Kaine and others, I think there should be a vote on authorization of use of military force. I don't think we should put America's men and women in harm's way without a robust debate in the Senate. And I think in the House and the Congress, and people should really.
So you think it was too rash?
I think it was rash, but I think the question is this. I hear Chuck Schumer saying, Turkey's not our ally, these guys aren't our ally. What are we there for? What's our objective? We should know what we're there for. What are kids dying for there?
It's a fair question, but you agree that it was rash. Karen, your response to this letter?
I just go back to, I'd like to know, I hope we learn more about what this deal was, because actually, as CNN reported on the 12th, it was that General Mazlum who said, you are leaving us to be slaughtered. So
right.
Clearly, whatever deal they thought might have been in place several days prior fell through. And we've now seen what's happened in the successive days.
And the letter is very unusual. Don't be a tough guy. History will look at you as the devil if good things don't happen. Don't be a fool.
And it's clear that they've also had several phone calls, which we know. I mean, the president has talked about this. But, it's a very unusual way for the president, and this president in particular, has, an amazing command of the bully pulpit to explain his position, to explain American foreign policy. There have been so many different viewpoints and contradictory things just over the last several days here. I think that the release of this does not sort of clarify it all, but give a speech to the nation. Say what the objective is. There's been nothing like that at all.
Right.
Yeah. So it is confusing.
And we should note that, the release of this letter also comes just as the House of Representatives just overwhelmingly, Democrats and Republicans, voted to rebuke the president for his decision to withdraw U.S. forces from northern Syria.